Yeah, she's a 65 and she's Tom's, and here's the details.
And what we're doing is we're going to be pulling the oil pan off the motor and putting a new rear main seal in it and resealing the oil pan. So that's basically what we're doing now. We've got two more bolts in the oil pan, one in each center here, and then we'll be dropping it off. Okay, we got the oil pan off, dropped off, and as you can see, they put silicone on both sides of the gasket, which is these style types of gasket is a big no-no. And as I was afraid of, we had to get into the corners here and pound in between the block and the pan and stuff and get it to it prized to break the seal loose between the gasket and the oil pan and the block. And what happens, as always, you bend the ellipse down here. So we got this corner, we got a little bit of the front corner down here, and we might have, and this side over here is a little bit, but this is the side here that finally broke, the seal finally broke loose from this side, so we could actually pry on it and wiggle it and pull down on it, and then this side finally gave loose. So we're gonna have to straighten the lip up on the oil pan there to make it straight so it will seal again. But that's what you get when you silicone on a non-silicone type gasket. Granted, you have a 50-50 shot of whether it's going to leak or not leak on neoprene gaskets. A lot of times you put silicone on them, they'll leak. So you don't want to put silicone on them unless you absolutely positively have to. This one here, however, was not going to leak. If any place it would leak is the front or the rear pan seal. So we'll put the same gasket back on it again, but we're not going to do all the goop and silicone on it like they did there, because it's not necessary. It doesn't need it.
Cool. Thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm.